And then I remembered that I was supposed to do 10 seconds of silence that I haven't been doing. Thank you all very much for tuning in, and welcome to episode 24 of The Lair of Lore. We are doing our plane shift of Kamigawa, because we actually decided that we're going to just cover all of the stories in one big fell swoop.
Mm-hmm. Yep, makes more sense. Instead of, and join us next week to find out what is going to happen. It's just better to do it all at once, so you get, like, the full scope of the story.
Yep. Though we do recommend that if you would like to stay slightly more up-to-date than we're going to be, go check out the Unspoken Realms podcast, because then you also don't even have to read. Just, you get to listen to the stories. Just remember mm-hmm. that they are about 2 weeks behind, because production time is a thing.
Yes.
So, we are doing our plane shift for Kamigawa, which, if you don't remember, plane shifts are a thing that Wizards does with most new sets, though their release schedule seems to be entirely arbitrary.
Doesn't actually make sense.
Yeah, some of them have come out after the first set, some of them came out just before the second set came out, some of them came
Kaladesh
out...
Kaladesh came out after Kaladesh Aether Revolt.
Came out about...
Like, way after Aether Revolt was released.
Kaladesh 1 came out about a month before amonkhet spoilers started.
And, like, 2 weeks after, we're like, are they actually going to do something with this?
And, in fact, some of us asked on Twitter, are you doing this? And got no response until... Almost 2 weeks later, they announced, by the way, we're totally doing this still, it's coming out! But, yeah. Mm. So, Plane Shift, we do our own, where we look at older planes that we don't expect are going to get an official Plane Shift. We do a really, really rough outline of what races we think would be good player character races, mm-hmm. and if there are any classes that we just don't think will work on that plane.
Yeah.
Or
I mean, we also sometimes
races.
Do, like, sometimes we'll do little things like, what kind of bonuses do they get? But we don't get too yeah. deep into the numbers, because that's inciting madness, just because, yeah.
Yeah, best that you'll ever hear from us is that we'll usually try and figure out what a race's bonuses will be. Like, not numerical, but, like, this race should probably get an int and a charisma bonus, that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And some outline of... what sort of bonuses they'll get in terms of, like, spellcasting, or, like, some races have an innate spellcasting, or some of them get a faster movement speed, or some of them mm-hmm. get, like, once-a-day abilities, that sort of stuff. So that's the sort of yep. stuff that we'll be trying to figure out. Just no hard numbers, because, yeah, theoretically, one day we will have that, but it's stuff that I'm doing in my free time in the slow, maddening build-up to trying to run a magic-based D&D campaign. Hopefully many years in the future, but we'll see. Hello, Demasu. Welcome to the chat.
Hey, Demasu.
Should also be said, sorry we are starting very late today because we had an hour of pre-show that we did not expect.
Like an hour and 15 minutes almost of
yeah,
pre-show.
Because we ended up talking about stupid wrestling stuff and...
And cocktails.
And trying to remember the word shibboleth, sorry, which I continue to mispronounce by adding an N.
Yes.
Yeah, it's an hour pre-show. You'll have fun with that, Demasu. if you want to hear that, those are all available as the extra bits, which are available on our Patreon. We'll go into mm-hmm. the big spiel about that later.
That's it. That comes at the end of the episode.
Yeah.
Let's go in order.
Yes, we did. We talked about wrestling for a lot of it, because Jack Gallagher yeah. is an impressive man. And
he's
because,
got a glorious mustache and a fancy umbrella.
And because The Undertaker retired and... it was, all in all, a, like, dude needed a new hip. Like, he needed to retire. But we have established in many past things that Roman Reigns and Jace are basically the same person, and I hate both of them. Like, in theory, they're totally fine, but their character development is non-existent. Therefore, I hate them.
We're also a little bit bummed because one of our favorite groups is not getting much...
Well, one of our favorite groups technically doesn't exist anymore. We really like...
I know, it hurt.
We really like the Vaudevillains, and one of them got let go. And one yeah. of them is hopefully doing a singles run, but we don't know for sure. Plus, he's a professional mm-hmm. singer, and it's very impressive. Look up Simon Gotch. The dude is just, like, impressive in every possible way. Now then, on to the actual thing. So, the races that we're definitely going to be talking about... We're not going to talk about humans, because humans are the goddamn same on every plane. No one cares.
They're like rabbits. You just you find them everywhere. They're
like
bunnies.
The only time that we will talk about humans is when there is a plane that doesn't have them, and I will be happy.
Yes.
We will be talking about the Soratami, the moon folk, the Nezumi, which are the rat people, the Kitsune, which are the fox people, gonna try and do the ogres, they're a little bit weird, the Aki, which is this plane's version of goblins, and we're gonna see about the Oni, because the reason I don't want to do spirits is because that most of the spirits are not sentient. They couldn't be a player character, really.
They're like spirits of things.
Yeah. The Oni, however, sort of are. Like, they're spirits of evil, negative concepts, but because of that seem to have more free will. I did not see the official announcement, but I do know that the next set has been announced. I can't pronounce it, which is why I'm not saying it. It's some sort of traditional Southern American inspired set from the naming convention, probably Mayan or Aztec.
Let me find it, because I tend to be okay with pronunciations.
I don't think you can. I'm sorry. I believe in you, but I don't think you can.
I'm gonna try it anyways.
Okay.
That just means I have to find it first, but I will be doing that on the side.
Okay, good. Oh, I did not see anything about a new Master Series. Hang on, what's this thing about a new Master Series? Yes, because apparently 25 years is so much more important than... No, new Master Series MTG, you piece of crap. There we go. Okay, well, I saw a price tag of $400, so that's always comforting.
Yeesh. Okay, I'm trying to find the announcement.
Don't worry, that's not what we're covering this episode.
Nope, it's more of a thing that I'm going to look for anyways, just out of curiosity.
Yes, stop looking for it now. We have an actual topic for this episode.
Like, we don't have a topic on our other episode?
Yes, but we have a topic that we actually need to go into because you're going to complain if we're not done soon enough.
Actually, not tonight. It's actually okay.
Don't you have to work tomorrow?
I do, but I'll be fine. But yeah, so should we just start from the top and work our way down?
I don't know what you mean by the top, but sure.
You gave me a list, the first on the list.
The one that I texted you that I don't... Okay. Well, hang on then. Okay, so Soratami, Moonfolk. The first thing I'm going to say right off the top here is probably an int bonus.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very much
Their whole thing is that they're, like, magic and spellcasty, and they're, like, basically wizards. They're the only race that is born a wizard, which is sort of contradictory to wizards in D&D, but whatever.
Yes.
Wizards in D&D, for those of you who don't know, are basically the people who, instead of, like, sorcerers being born with magic, or some other ones drawing magic from their gods, or from nature, or, like, warlocks who go find a big powerful being and basically staple some of its power onto themselves, wizards go out and study magic. They're not born with any innate talent or anything, they just go out and figure out how it works, usually at school.
Yep, they're like, okay.
So...
I'm gonna study this.
Besides that, I'm going to say I feel like they should get a spellcasting ability.
Yes. Like, what kind of thing were you thinking about?
Well, so normally the way that getting a spellcasting ability works is they get a cantrip, and then they get to cast a second level spell at third level, and a third level spell at fifth level. I think they should do that, except that I think they should get to pick.
Okay.
So basically, from the very beginning, they pick... This. I've been thinking about this one a little bit too much, so I have more of the nuts and bolts worked out. But I feel like level one, you pick a school of magic. Like evocation, abjuration, one of those. You pick one cantrip, and when you hit third level, you pick one second level spell. And then when you hit fifth level, you pick one third level spell. And just those are the ones you get. They have to come from the wizard spell school, because wizard.
But
otherwise, they're just spells that no matter what class you are, you always have them.
Do you think that they get any specific cantrips just because of...
Well, no, because you only get one cantrip for any of the other races that have this thing. I'm saying that unlike all the other ones that go, hey, you get this specific cantrip, these guys get to pick it.
Yeah, okay. I can dig it.
Okay.
Again, I've not played Wizard before, so my knowledge of, like, Wizard-y stuff is a little, like...
So the thing is, when you look at all the spells in the book...
Yeah.
Almost 75% of them are only castable by wizards.
Yes.
Because wizards just do all the spells. But that's why I'm saying that we give them that rule of it has to be from one school.
Yes.
So, like, they're born with some amount of innate skill in, like, evocation or abjuration or necromancy or something. So it makes them more limited.
Yes.
Because while, yes, they might take a damage... like a powerful damage spell is the cantrip that is a little bit better than any of the other races get to start with. That means that they're trapped with evocations at second and third level, which don't tend to be that great.
Okay. All right. I can dig it.
Yeah.
It makes sense. I mean, with wizards, it's intelligence and wisdom.
No, well, I'm just saying that okay, so the way that spellcasting things work is...
Oh, no, sorry. I was looking. I have up stuff
for wizards. We're just doing race, remember?
Mm-hmm.
So the way that the races do it whenever they get a spellcasting thing is you have a bonus in X ability. That's the ability you use for spellcasting, so they just will use int.
Cool.
I feel like they might get one other minor ability, but I think that spellcasting sort of balances everything out.
Yeah, because I picture if you choose to play a moonfolk, they're going to be, I don't think they're going to be very, like, strong.
No, they might get a minor whiz bonus too.
Yeah.
But nothing amazing.
Yeah.
But I feel like they might get some other slight thing. I'm just not sure what it would be.
I don't know. I'm like... My brain is like, charisma, but my brain is always like, charisma.
Yeah, they're not really charismatic.
No, I picture them like very aloof.
Very. In fact, one of their castles literally floats above a waterfall.
Yeah, so.
Floats above a waterfall.
Kind of hard to get to, I think. Enigmatic.
That's they're literally bunny rabbit people.
Yes, I'm aware of that.
Yeah.
Magical bunny rabbit people.
Because weird folklore about bunnies living on the moon. No, I am not joking about this.
Well, I think it has something to do with the way they see, like, the Japanese see the moon. It's instead of a face like we see, it's a rabbit. It's a rabbit that lives on the moon.
And needs mochi, yes.
Yes.
The Japanese have some very strange folklore because they also have folklore about, what's her name? Kaguya. Princess Kaguya. The girl in the bamboo that fell from the moon.
Okay, yeah.
That's like one of the first recorded science fiction stories. It's very strange.
Huh.
The Japanese have some odd stuff in terms of folklore. And that's where most of the inspiration for Kamigawa is coming from. So, I think there might be a minor benefit here, but I think that that's going to be one of those things we come back and deal with. What was next on my list?
You had Nozumi. I think I pulled it up in order. Because it was Kamigawa. It was, excuse me. Sorotomi, Nozumi, Kitsune. It was Kitsune, Sorotomi, Nozumi, Oki, and maybe the Oni.
Okay, well, let's do Kitsune next, because that's the next one I wrote.
Yeah.
So...
Okay. I was having a hard time really finding too much about the Kitsune. I know they're, like, fox. They have to do with, like...
Yeah, they're fox people. They tend to have a big thing about honor and being like, healers and samurai.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure where to go with that. Like, I'm inclined to say maybe some amount of wisdom bonus, and then I'd almost say, like, wisdom and strength.
Yes.
Maybe wisdom and... Dex, because they're more, like, lithe, but then...
I think maybe you can choose. Hang on. My brain is like, give them the choice, and then don't actually give them the choice.
No, that's mostly fine, I think. Yeah, give them a choice between.
You can either choose to be have a dex bonus or a strength bonus, I think.
Yeah.
Because depending on kind of how you design your character, I feel like either be like very like
you could be monkish or you could be samurai, which generally gets sort of written as the paladin.
Yeah, that makes sense. So like we'll give them a choice depending on how they play their character.
Yeah, and technically you could play a dex paladin, but it takes more work.
Yes.
So I feel like they should get some amount of early training, but like choice of like martial weapons. Just like no matter what class they are, they get proficiency in two martial weapons, I want to say.
Yes.
Okay. And
because I mean especially like I'm thinking like samurai in my brain, because you have your long, you have your katana, and then you have the two short knives.
Which I guess are exotic weapons, but D&D 5th edition doesn't really have a thing for exotic weapons right now.
Well, I mean, wouldn't it be almost like a, like, I feel like it would be somewhere between a rapier and a longsword.
What, the katana?
Yeah.
No, a katana is just a longsword.
Okay, then yeah, longsword then.
I'm talking about...
So that's easy.
I'm talking about the jite or size, which are effectively, like, there's not really an equivalent for them, to be completely honest.
Mm-hmm.
So I would just sort of ignore that and just say they get training in, I would say, two martial weapons of their choice.
Yeah.
And maybe, like, longbow?
Okay.
Just to give them a ranged weapon, too.
Yeah, because, fascinatingly enough, the Japanese do have their own version of a...
You muted out for that last bit.
Sorry. There is a Japanese-style longbow, which is different from a Western-style one.
Yes, it's significantly larger, if I recall.
Yeah.
And we're not...
I feel like you can only use that if you have the strength bonus, though.
Functionally,
or is that too limiting?
That is too limiting and functionally doesn't apply for Kamigawa or... Okay. To be honest, that whole thing about... archers being these secret badasses in Dark Ages is entirely bullshit. Please stop there's a stupid list of unsighted shit from, like, Reddit and Imgur that goes around every couple of months that is all unsighted and is just crap. Hello, Flontes? I want to say... Flontes, but I'm not sure if that's quite right.
Flufonts. Hi, welcome.
Okay. So yeah, proficiency in two martial weapons of their choice and longbow.
Yes.
I feel like that's still sort of a minor benefit, but I don't know what else to give them, to be completely honest.
I mean, they're kind of lycanthropy.
Not really, no. Mm. The whole thing of a lycanthrope is that they change.
Ah, these don't change.
Yeah, no. They have one thing.
Oh.
Like...
Clerics and skilled fighters.
Oh, and medium armor, I say.
Okay, maybe a survival bonus?
They don't
Something
really have...
survival?
I would say that's an Izumi thing.
Okay. All right, we'll go with like the armor thing.
Yeah, it's
because I'm just like
because remember that survival is living out in the wild.
Yeah.
And these are very civilized. Like these are the White Aligned tribe.
Okay.
I'm just trying to look because I mean, the problem is there's just not a lot of lore about them, to be completely honest.
I know, right? That's what's driving me nuts, is it's like, and I'm trying to find something about it, but like,
yeah, and there is
not a lot.
All of the extra stuff in the articles that can be dug up on the Wayback Machine. We don't want to go digging through the Wayback Machine, though, to find a couple of story articles about one, frankly, kind of forgotten race that has never been used again.
Exactly. So it's just like, how do we... I kind of like what...
Dark vision. They're foxes. Okay, they would definitely get some kind of dark vision.
Da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, that one totally makes sense.
Yeah. I feel like this might be just a we'll have to come back, because I really can't think of too much else that they would get.
I mean, maybe 35 movement speed? Instead of standard 30? I feel like foxes tend to be really quick.
I'm gonna put a question mark next to it, but yeah, I can understand that one.
Yeah, we'll go with that, because I can see them being kind of swift.
Yeah.
Especially, like, if you choose a dex bonus.
Yeah. Well, then let's move on to the Nizumi. So, the rat people.
Not a lot of info.
First things first, I'm saying, yeah, they get a survival bonus.
Yes.
I'm also sort of inclined to say that they would get, like, a con and probably a dex bonus to start with.
Yep, okay.
I'd almost say,
kind of handy, kind of, like, very, hardy.
They live in horrible places. It's less hardy and more they're used to breathing literal poison.
Oh, yes, then. Very much so, yes, then.
I'm almost inclined to say that it would be, like, a +2 in both of them, and then they would get a minus because charisma. Rat people.
Yes. That actually fits in the little teeny tiny bit of lore that I found for them. As they live in a bog.
And they just are not trusted generally because
there's kind of like mischief.
A lot of it is sort of portrayed as they're mischievous because people expect them to be, so it's easier for them to be mischievous than not.
Got it. Oh, this is some Nizumi shamans use incantations to summon and control and distract their enemies. That's lovely.
I assume you said insects because you got muted for that half of that.
Yes, swarms of creepy bugs.
Yeah.
Eek. Let's see. Ninja, gang leader, necromancer.
I'm writing down bug magic with question mark. I think there is a spell for, like, an infestation, but I need to go look it up before saying that they would just get it. Don't worry about looking it up now.
No, I'm still trying to find stuff for Akis, because I haven't been able to find...
They're goblins.
...a lot of stuff. Okay.
Yeah, they're goblins that literally roll down hills. They're very durable.
Okay, so... Nizumi. Con and dex bonuses. Minus charisma bonus.
Yup.
What else? So, bug-type magic, yes.
Yeah, some sort of bug magic, maybe.
Proficiency with thieves' tools?
Oh, yeah, that works.
Yeah, because, like, stealing, raiding, ninja-type stuff.
Thieves' tools. Oh, actually, in addition to survival, I want to give them the stealth bonus.
Yes, that makes total sense. Almost roguey bits? There's a little bit of roguiness in there?
Yeah, I mean, they also have samurai, but their samurai are generally considered more mercenary. So, quite frankly, more accurate to real samurai.
Ooh, actually, this Art of Ink Eyes is really good on the one that I'm looking at.
I think that's about what we're good with, though. Because, I mean,
yeah.
I will check what Infestation does. I believe it's an Unearthed Arcana spell, but I feel like that's an okay one.
Hmm.
I think this, frankly, so far, this is looking like one of the most balanced ones we've done.
Like, the easiest.
Yeah, which I was not expecting.
Yeah, I'm like, rat people, what are we going to do with that? And then even just, like, in the couple of paragraphs that we found of, like, here's some lore. Okay. It's just like, oh, actually, excuse me, singular paragraph.
I don't know what you're going off of. I have picked up lore over years of playing the game.
Yeah, for me, I found a single paragraph.
Is this an MTG Salvation Wiki thing?
Yeah.
Remember that everything there is probably not true.
Yes, I'm aware of that. Okay. However, for me, it's giving me a little guidance because remember, I didn't play Kamigawa.
Neither did I. So. That's why I'm saying just base what you know off of it's a rat person and Japanese mythology.
Yes.
Yeah. Don't trust MTG Salvation.
So far is like the most straightforward that we've been able to find. Or do, because it's like, oh, yeah, this totally makes sense for rat people living in swamps.
Yeah. So. Okay. For the Aki, the first I'm definitely going to say is con bonus.
Yes.
Because their entire thing is that they have the stupid rock thing on their back.
Mm-hmm.
Because they roll down mountains.
That'll work.
Yeah, they're really strange.
Okay.
They also have a thing with lava magic, but that's not all of them, so I don't know what to do with that one. This might be one of those cases where we don't use the goblin just because
I really don't think you can.
The problem is that these goblins are so small, and while they have a lot of character, their character is basically they're angry stone-like hedgehogs. There are individual Aki with great flavor. However, most of the stuff they do is not repeatable. So, like, Kiki Jiki, the Mirror Breaker, is an amazing individual Aki with some amount of story attached to it, but...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's not something that anyone else can do.
I mean... Yeah, I don't know what you can do with these right now. Because, like, even... they've got slings, they literally look like little... They look like spiky devil armadillos.
Yeah.
That's like how I would describe it. Devil armadillos.
Yeah.
Like,
I like them. They're just not that... There's not that much to them, to be completely honest.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it just...
I feel like they might actually just also be a touch too small to be a player character, because these are even smaller than normal goblins.
Oh, okay. So, yeah. I am doubting their playability, to be honest. Yeah.
I'm going to keep them on the list just in case, but I don't think there's too much more we can do with them.
I think they could be, like, something you could fight or flavor or, like, NPCs, but not, like, an actual easily playable character.
Yeah.
Because they use slings, apparently. Looks like they use slings, and there's just not a lot for them.
Yeah. So then up next, I moved away, is the ogres. So first things first, strength. They get a strength bonus.
Yeah. Yes. Very much so.
Yeah. Maybe a con bonus, but not necessarily. That's just the only other one I can think of that they would definitely qualify.
Like, just big.
They are large. I mean, they're not stupid big, but they are definitely large.
Yeah. Okay.
They have a thing about blood, too.
Eh. Like blood magic?
Usually drinking blood, but yes, also blood magic.
Okay.
Yeah,
interesting. And, like...
Yeah.
Yeesh.
They're black-red aligned, so they are in general not nice people.
Hmm. Definitely strength. Possibly con. Do they worship? What are they? Okay.
I don't know if they worship anything, to be completely honest. I think it's one of those, they follow the strongest, and that's good enough for them. They have a thing with, oh god, who's their, not leader, but the one legend that they have, Hitsuge? I want to say it's Hitsuge.
Hidetsugu?
Hang on.
Hidetsugu. And is he a shaman?
I'm...
Ogre shaman?
Yes, I know, hang on. Yes, Heartless Hidetsugu.
Okay.
Sorry. because technically Kamigawa is pronounced the same way as Japanese, everything has a very specific way that it is supposed to be pronounced, even if Wizard sometimes mispronounces their own crap.
Yeah.
Yeah. Heartless Hidetsugu, yes, because E is always pronounced as an A because it's annoying like that.
Hidetsugu.
No, hard A. Hidetsugu. Oh.
Hidetsugu. Yeah. Okay.
Interesting. Yeah, no, you got it right the first time. That's why I was agreeing with you.
How is that? How does that happen? That like when I try to think about it, that, it's like when I try it, when I just try saying it, it's like, oh, that makes sense. And then when I think about it, it's like, don't make sense. Don't just say it right.
Don't look at too many Kamigawa cards in question because it will hurt a lot. He also has a ritual, but hang on here. Gatherer. No, I said Oh my god, I clicked on Gatherer. And it took me back to the awful magic website. Why? Right, I hate using Gatherer. I have a tablet right here.
His second rate.
What? Yeah, his second rate.
Yeah, the card.
Where is
damage. Damage dealer.
Sort of, yeah. Okay. Did you read the card?
Yeah. I literally pulled it up right now.
Okay.
Yeah. If target player has exactly 10 life, Hidetsugu's second rate deals 10 player.
That's less damage dealer, more just, oops, I win now.
Yes.
I
like the flavor text.
I'm just trying to find all the ogre cards really quick. From this set.
There's a lot more ogres than I thought there were.
Yep, there's a lot.
Generally. Yeah.
Well, so the ogres are the other reason why I want to briefly touch on the Oni, because the ogres serve and or are controlled by the Oni. It's a little bit weird.
Okay.
But yeah, the entire thing that the ogres have is that generally they're really, they tend to be kind of inexpensive and usually aren't all that great unless there's an Oni around.
Okay.
But they're also just like strong and bloodthirsty murderers. And I mean thirsty. They will drink it.
Okay. So let's think. What sort of stuff can we do with this?
Probably
strength,
some...
yes. Con, yes.
Some kind of regeneration if time is spent to eat their opponent.
Fun. Okay.
Yeah.
Interesting. You have to remember to eat the corpse of your enemies.
Yeah.
Or take from the corpse of your enemies. Much like trying to feed the mace kind of thing that Stephanie has. So let's see. So that could make sense. Do you think there's any sort of like minuses that they get?
Not really. I mean,
I don't imagine them being particularly dexterous.
Yes, but not in such a way that I think they get a minus. Remember that generally if you're giving them a minus, it's either because they are actively worse than a vanilla human or because you have given them significant bonuses in another field and need to compensate, and we haven't really done that.
Yeah, no, I mean, like, I'm assuming they're essentially as dexterous as their size will allow.
Pretty much, yeah. Like,
nothing too detrimental, but nothing too, like, oh my god, you're so flexible.
Okay, just looking at all of the ogres, I feel like they have to have proficiency with... Let me check the name of the weapon before I commit. Except that I've set the book down somewhere dumb. Hang on. Aha! No matter what class they are, I feel like they should get some proficiency with... God damn it, why is it somewhere in the middle? I had to go past it twice, both ways, apparently. There we go. With a...
The giant, like, spiky mace thingy?
Yeah, literally every one of them seems to have. With a maul.
Ew, yeah. Yes. Yes, they do. Oh my god, giant spike thingy.
Yeah, just all of them, no matter what class you're using, just, I can use big hitty stick.
With spikies.
Yeah.
With all the spikies.
I mean, technically it does bludgeoning, but it'll be fine.
Yeah, I feel like the spikes will hurt, but the bludgeoning is what does it. Like, swung by a creature of that size. Because damn.
Yeah, but I feel like there's still going to be something else there.
Do you think they're going to be using a lot of magic?
No. Like, some of them are shamans and have connections with the demons and can do horrible, horrible blood death things, but I don't think most of them are.
Got it.
I just don't know what else to give them.
I don't... Like we were talking about, they shouldn't have anything taken, but...
Oh. I'm trying to remember which one is which. I'm willing to say just they can understand and to some degree speak... I don't remember which one speaks which, but I'm almost inclined to just say Infernal and Abyssal. The demon and devil languages.
Yeah, I can see that.
Weirdly, I almost want to give them a bonus for any sort of charisma checks involving demons and devils.
Okay. I can see it.
I just don't know what, but yeah.
Okay, so Abyssal is demons. So I think Infernal is devils?
I think it generally is. There are also devils who speak Abyssal just for the sake of confusion, but yeah.
Of course.
Like,
of course it doesn't have to make sense.
Theoretically, it's devils, then demons are higher up. But devils are also more organized, so they have some more respect for order, but there are really powerful devils, too, so it's weird.
Okay.
For...
That was a strange comment in... Okay.
Yep.
Interesting. Yeah, moving on. Okay. I don't imagine them being super charismatic otherwise.
No, but I don't think they'll get a bonus, but I don't think they should get a negative either.
Agreed. Again... Big, ugly, not stupid, but not amazingly intelligent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Heavy
armor, maybe?
I don't think so. I feel like they should be allowed to do the same as,
like... Your cloak is choking you.
What?
Sorry. The button on my cloak was, like, right up against my neck, and I'm like, that's not comfortable.
I don't feel like they need it because I feel like a lot of them are going to end up being barbarians, to be honest.
Yes.
So I think we can
that
just...
That makes...
I think we can move on to our question mark.
Okay.
So the Oni...
Question mark it?
I just don't know about the Oni, to be completely honest.
Mm-hmm.
Because... So the reason why we're not doing the spirits in general is because... The spirits on Kamigawa, not only are they not the dead, they're living embodiments of people's ideas about, or people's feelings about physical objects and ideas. So they don't, they're not sentient, they don't have free will, they have, they're effectively programmed.
It's almost
programmed.
Like they kind of... They just kind of exist.
Yeah, they're programs that function in very specific ways in response to very specific stimuli. Sometimes that stimuli is this big, extra, super powerful spirit is telling us to go kill a whole bunch of mortals.
Yeah.
But they don't have free will, so I don't think they can have a planeswalker spark.
Mm-hmm.
The Oni, however, seem to, because they are malicious ideas... that seem to be born from much more specific events or occasions, seem to have a lot more personal freedom. Hmm. Like, I don't know if they have full-on free will, but they definitely have some amount of self-determination.
Yeah.
So because of that, I feel like we've seen demon planeswalkers. Admittedly, the one that I'm thinking of was a human that turned into a demon. But...
Okay.
If that's a thing, then I feel like a Kamigawan Oni could probably have a Planeswalker spark.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to figure out what they would do beyond probably being perplexingly charismatic. and having some sort of bonus to, like, intimidation?
Yes. I think that's a good one.
But I feel like they'd be, like, charismatic and strong.
Yes.
Hey, welcome, Zinchling.
I mean, if you look at, like, any of the things, it's... Hulking is the word I would describe.
Yeah, almost all of the Oni are massive.
Like
even there's a like there's an Oni
grotesquely hulky.
There's an Oni ninja from Plane Chase that is just like his arms are the size of his head, and he's a ninja. Yeah. What the hell?
Silent Blade Oni.
Yep, that one.
Demon ninja.
Yeah, because that's a good thing.
I don't know how spikes on your head are super, like...
I think he's a ninja in that everything that sees him then dies.
Yeah, I mean, he's kind of creepy looking.
Yeah. What did I say that I thought they had a charisma bonus for? Like, they had a charisma bonus as their racial thing.
And intimidation.
No, they had a charisma bonus, but then there was something specific that they could do with charisma.
You said intimidation?
Oh, intimidation. Okay.
That's what you said? Yeah. Which makes sense. I'd be intimidated by these.
Yeah.
Let's be honest.
Damn it, now I have to go censor that. Thank you.
What? Ah.
Yep.
It's only on ladies that we can wear.
No, you're not supposed to do it there either, but I don't censor it there.
Fair enough. Yeah, sorry.
Somewhere around 49:30, I have to censor. Okay.
Yes, big, hulky, scary things. Oddly charismatic, I could see that. Abyssal and languages.
I feel like because they're actually demons, they would just speak Abyssal.
Okay. So there's that.
I feel
magic?
Like, yeah, I feel like they should get some sort of magic or some sort of very low-level possession.
Okay.
I mean, I don't even know if possession or if just a, like, can work together with a willing host. I'm just not sure.
Okay, dude.
But definitely some low-level magic.
Yeah. Because I'm like, my brain is like, oh, can you lend strength? Lend your strength to someone if they give you, like, if they make a pact with you?
I feel like it wouldn't be lend strength, because the Oni that we see in Kamigawa are not about lending strength. They're about, hey, buddy, give me your body. I'm gonna wear it like a skin suit, and we're gonna go kill that guy.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
The latest haute couture.
Yeah.
Skin suits.
Yeah. Yeah. I just don't know how that would function in the game. But yeah, I think they should have some kind of magic, just have it tied to necromancy and blood magic. I'm going to write down possession and just have it as a, like, must figure out. Because I like the idea a lot.
Maybe they can only use spells from specific classes?
Like
necromancy?
Well, no. When I'm saying magic, I'm saying that they'll probably get, like, two spells. I'm saying that in my head, I'm going to limit them to things like necromancy, yeah. Or if it's something else, it has to in some way be tied artificially to blood magic.
Yes. Okay. But yeah, limit their spells.
Yeah.
Because it's funny, because it's definitely... maybe charisma is their spell modifier?
Almost certainly, yeah.
Yeah, like, because I'm trying to, like, picture in my head, just, like, trying to deal with them, how they might interact with other characters.
I think that for sure these are going to be one of the ones where we have to look over them and go, okay, they cannot be X, Y, and Z classes.
Yes.
So, I think we're good here. Let's do a quick run through of the things that we did this time.
Okay.
So we have the Soratami, which we decided are getting an int bonus, and are going to have the normal spellcasting thing for races, where they'll get three different spells as they level up, but they get to pick them, but they'll also be limited to one school.
Yes.
That they pick at level one.
Yes. Then
the Kitsune, we decided we'll get a wisdom bonus, and then mm-hmm. they'll pick if they want a strength or dex bonus, basically monk yes. or samurai, and that they would be proficient with two martial weapons and a longbow, along with proficiency.
They also get a little bit of a speed bonus.
Yeah, minor speed bonus, dark vision, and proficiency with medium armor. The Nezumi, frankly, should probably also get dark vision, but
yes.
we said they're getting a bonus for dex and constitution while losing mm-hmm. charisma because they're rats. What the hell? No one likes looking at a rat. Sorry.
Not really. Well, I mean, I understand people have pet rats, but they're not a standard everyone likes yeah. them type thing.
Well, now imagine that pet rat being 4 to 5 feet tall and smelling like a swamp.
Oh, yeah. Lovely.
Then we give them survival and stealth training.
Yep.
We're trying to figure out some sort of bug magic because there is a bug spell, but I need to look them all up before I yeah. agree with that. And proficiency yep. with thieves' tools, and yeah, dark vision because mm-hmm. they're rats. What the hell?
Yep, they're rats and they live in a swamp.
We haven't been able to figure out anything for the Aki because they're the most minor goblins, quite frankly, of magic. Ogres, we were going to do strength and con bonuses, some kind of regeneration if eating enemy corpses or drinking enemy blood, sort of vampire-esque, I guess. No matter what class they are proficient with a maul, which
yep,
is...
Yep, big ol' spiky thing on a stick.
Read as basically the largest, most heavy-hitting bludgeoning tool for D&D, and they can speak and understand in Abyssal and Infernal, with some sort of bonus for communicating with devils and demons.
Mm-hmm.
Oni are charismatic and strong. Intimidation as a basic bonus. They'll get some very low-level magic, no matter what, related to necromancy or blood magic.
Yes.
Speak Abyssal, and I'm going to try and figure out some way to make a, hey buddy, come here, I'm going to wear you as a skin suit, and we're going to hit him together as a thing.
Like a possession type. Thing.
Yeah, a possession, but very much the Oni takes over, and the person probably gets their body back, but not all of it completely functioning the way it should.
Okay, so they could take, so they definitely, okay, hang on, I'm thinking.
It's, whatever it would be, it would definitely be a once-a-day thing, and a, it's not good for anyone involved thing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Can you get stuck in a body?
No, because I imagine that they just get, like, knocked back out of it after a certain amount of time.
Okay. Definitely take damage, though.
Yeah, the body and the Oni.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, how much do you want to possess this person?
Yeah.
How badly do you need to possess this person?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I think that's pretty good. So really quickly...
It's a good start.
Are there any classes you don't think, period, will work on this plane?
No.
Okay, that's what I was thinking too.
Because I'm like bard. Yep, got lots of instruments. Yeah. Easy. Paladin. Literally like a
samurai. Generally tend to get roleplayed as paladin. Yeah.
Yep. Wizard. We already talked about that with the Soratami. They're kind of wizardy to start with.
Yeah, sorcerer. Plenty of people get power from Oni or Kami.
Oh, okay. Druids. How would a druid work on this plane?
Druid works literally anywhere.
Okay, so yes, we keep druids.
Yeah. Oh, I just remembered. There's a race we forgot.
What did we forget?
The race that has the most druids. The Orochi.
The spell that for me?
I want to say it's O-R-O-C-H-I.
Oh, okay.
The snake people who, in deference to being snake people, have four arms.
Because that makes sense.
Because this plane right. doesn't have elves. This plane has Orochi instead.
Okay, so they're the druidy type.
Among other things. So yeah. One thing I'm definitely going to say is probably dex and whiz bonus because they're basically god blessed wood elves.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it. They're the wood elves of...
Yeah, but I feel like they're still better. Like, I'm inclined to give them the... Yonti stuff of, like, immunity to poison and the ability to do a, like, poison bite.
Yes, okay. Orochi sustainer, Orochi leaf coupler, egg washer. Okay, Orochi archmage.
Yeah. So the one thing that I'm trying to figure out is they have four arms.
Mm-hmm.
That sort of makes everything work weird.
Hmm.
Like, I'm... I went and looked it up, Damasu, don't worry. We will probably talk about it next week. I'm almost inclined to say that they... Like, willing to say that there are certain items that they can use more of.
Okay.
I'm just trying to figure out exactly how to balance it.
Not make it a broken thing.
Like, I'm trying to figure out...
Because that could get easily broken.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out, it's just like, okay. Like, I guess if you took dual wielding, you could, theoretically, as an Orochi, dual wield two-handed weapons? Just like, on this side, I'm holding a maul, and on this side with two arms, I'm holding a different thing. Just,
oh. But you should get, like, a, I don't know, deduction somehow with that.
Yeah, I feel like...
You don't hit with your full...
Yeah, no matter what, you're definitely not hitting with full power on any of them. But,
no, because...
But the problem is that...
Holy shit.
If you...
Sorry. Oh, bugger. That's another one.
Yeah, but that's one that I don't feel quite as bad about not censoring. Still, get better about that, dang it.
Yeah, sorry.
The
swearing.
The issue that I'm already seeing with this is, well, then someone can just do a normal dual wield and just have two shields. It's like, that also kind of cheaty McBuggerson, but okay.
Yeah.
I'm just going to write down four arms, how does work.
Yeah, because like...
And try and figure that one out myself. I feel like just the forearm thing, if I get it working, is going to be way more of a balancing thing than anything else this class is going to have. So I don't feel like they need more.
No. Like, even just looking at the Orochi card, you got the whole gamut. There's, like, spellcasters, there's rangers.
To be fair, you have that with most of the races.
Oh, hey, there's a picture of someone wielding four swords.
Yeah. so we'll come back to that and figure that out.
How does that actually work?
I don't know. I'll come figure that out before we do any sort of campaign.
Light weapons, maybe.
If they're using all four weapons, yes, it will have to be light no matter what. Looking over this, the one thing that I'm definitely going to say is that I don't think Oni can be paladins. Like, not even an Oathbreaker paladin, just no paladin.
No.
Yeah.
They stand literally against all of them.
Well, Oathbreaker paladins also do that, but it implies that at some point you could take an oath, which I don't think they can. But otherwise, like, even, I can't even come up with a good excuse for Oni to not be bards, because it's just like, you can be a dark god of music, or a dark spirit of bad, evil music.
Yeah, I mean, hell, there's stuff where Apollo drives people crazy with his harp.
Yeah.
I mean, just thinking of gods of music that I can think of just off the top of my head, like, you can send people into a panic.
Yeah, I just don't know.
I feel like, what is it? It's the thing where the voice in your mocking whisper? Or what is it called?
Vicious Mockery.
Vicious Mockery.
Yeah.
They would be really good at Vicious Mockery. Almost like, it's in their nature to be good at Vicious Mockery.
Yeah.
That evil little voice in your head sucks so bad.
But yeah, I don't think except for that, I don't think we have any classes we can't use or have to say that we can't use.
Huh. Yeah. That's kind of cool.
Yeah. Well, this was a downright, like, almost reasonable length episode for us.
I think it was balanced out by our super long pre-show.
Yeah. Yeah, the pre-show is very long. And there's probably going to be some post-show after it, too, so that'll be fun.
Oh, totally.
One of these, we need to get back onto recording these earlier in the day.
Yeah. I think if it wasn't, because I think it was a Thursday, I also worked and was like, I just need to like take some quiet time.
Yeah.
And not people for a while. So. Sometimes.
Really quickly, any final thoughts, things you want to talk about before we head out?
No.
Okay.
No. I'll give a solid no.
Yeah, I'll give a quick final spiel because we now have a much more short and succinct end slate that will explain all of it anyway, but I'll go through really quickly. Thank you all very much for watching. If you would like to get in contact with Miriam or I, you can do that on Twitter at lairoflore.com, or sorry, at lairoflore. You can find us on Facebook at lairoflore. You can email us at masterminds@lairoflore.com. Find everything we do at lairoflore.com. You can support what we do here on our Patreon. That's patreon.com/lairoflore, where you can get access to the pre- and post-show of this show and our D&D podcast and our other D&D show, along with plenty of other stuff. There are 4 different tiers that you can back us at, including just $1 a month that gets you the Derpy Puppy feed and our eternal gratitude. So thank you all very much for watching. We're now going to go to a silly, dumb post show where we probably continue to talk about dumb, silly, goofy stuff.
Yeah,
before both of us likely go pass out.
Yeah, I even thought of a pun.
Oh, God. Well, let's stop this recording and then we'll do the pun. Thank you all so very much for watching. Please remember to like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, and consider checking out some of the videos that are playing around this and maybe even supporting us on Patreon or any of our other sites like our website, Facebook, Twitter. They're all down below. Check them out.